नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द हर्पीज वायरस। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर आरती, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पैथोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर विद द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ हर्पीज वायरस। इट इज एन एनवेलप डबल स्टैंडर्ड डीएनए वायरस। द जीनोम कंसिस्ट ऑफ लॉन्ग एंड शॉर्ट फ्रेगमेंट्स विच मे बी ओरिएंटेड इन ईदर डायरेक्शन, गिविंग अ total of 4 isomers. 3 subfamilies are there: alpha herpes virus family, beta herpes virus family, and gamma herpes family. In alpha 1, HSV 1, 2, and varicella zoster virus is there. In beta, cytomegalovirus, herpes 6, herpes 7 is there. In gamma, Epstein-Barr virus and herpes virus 8 is there. Set up latent or persistent infection following primary infection. Reactivation are more likely to take place during period of immune suppression, and both primary infection and reactivation likely to be more serious in immune compromised patients. Now, we will talk about the herpes simplex now. It belongs to alpha herpes family. This is a double stranded DNA enveloped virus. The genome of HSV 1 and 2 share 50 to 70% homology. It is very identical, and it is very difficult to distinguish from the electron microscopy also. They also share several cross-reactive epitopes with each other. There is also antigenic cross-reaction with varicella zoster virus. Man is the only natural host for the herpes simplex virus. What is the epidemiology? Herpes simplex virus is spread by contact, as the virus is in shed of saliva, tear, genital, and other secretion. By far, the most common form of the infection result from the kiss given to the child or adult from a person shedding the virus. Primary infection is usually trivial and subclinical in most individuals. It is a disease mainly of very young children, that is below 5 years. There are two peaks of incidences. The first has 0 to 5 years and second in the late teenage, when sexual activity commences. About 10% of the population acquire the HSV infection, though the genital route and the risk is concentrated in young and adulthood. Generally, HSV 1 causes infection above the belt and HSV 2 below the belt. Matlab, if we divide the body into two parts, above the belt, above the lining of the navel, if there is an infection, this is mostly HSV 1 infection, and sometime, but it can be vice versa also. Following primary infection, 45% of the orally infected individual and 60% of the patient with genital herpes will experience recurrences, and the actual frequency of recurrence varies widely between individuals. The mean number of episodes per year is 1 to 6. What is pathogenesis? During the primary infection, HSV spread locally and short-lived viremia occurs, whereby the virus is disseminated in the body. Spread of the craniospinal ganglia occurs. The virus then establishes latency in the craniospinal ganglia. The exact mechanism of latency is not known. Reactivation is well known when many triggers can evoke a recurrence. These include physical and psychological stress, infection, any other immune-compromised condition. Clinical features are acute gingivostomatitis, herpes labialis, ocular herpes, herpes genitalis, other form of cutaneous herpes, meningitis, encephalitis, and neonatal herpes is there. One by one, we will discuss acute gingivostomatitis. Acute gingivostomatitis is the commonest manifestation in primary herpetic infection. The patient experiences pain and bleeding of the gum. Ulcers are also there, with the necrotic bases are present. Neck glands are commonly enlarged, usually a self-limiting disease. Herpes labialis, this is also called the cold sore. Following primary infection, 45% of the orally infected individual will experience reactivation. The actual frequency of recurrence varies widely between individuals. Herpes labialis is recurrence of oral HSV, and prodrome of tingling, warmth of itching at the site usually shows the recurrence. See, it is a gingivostomatitis. Ocular herpes, if we will talk, causes a broad spectrum of ocular disease, ranging from the mild superficial lesion involving the external eye to the severe sight-threatening disease of the inner eye. Disease caused include primary HSV, recurrence HSV, HSV conjunctivitis, and iridocyliositis, and chorioretinitis and cataract. Genital herpes, we will talk, primary, recurrent, and initial can be the lesion. Many sites can be involved, which involve the penis, vagina, cervix, anus, vulva, bladder, sacral nerve roots, and the spinal and meninges. The lesions of the genital herpes are particularly prone to secondary bacterial infection, that is Staphylococcus aureus, Staphylococcus, Trichomonas, Candida albicans. Dysuria is a common complaint there. Local sensory nerve may be involved, leading to development of the radiculitis. A mild meningitis may be present. 60% of the patient with genital herpes will experience recurrence. In herpes simplex encephalitis, it is one of the most serious complications of the herpes simplex disease. This is a neonatal and focal disease. Neonatal, there is a global involvement and the brain is almost liquefied. In focal disease, the temporal lobe is most commonly affected. This form of the disease appears in children and adults. It is possible that many of these cases arises from reactivation of the viruses. The mortality rate is high, 70% without treatment. It is of utmost importance to make a diagnosis of HSE early. It is a general practice that IV acyclovir is a given in all cases of the suspected HSE before laboratory results are available. Now, neonatal herpes. The incidence of neonatal herpes varies inexplicably from the country to country. The baby is usually infected with perinatally during the passage through the birth canal. Premature rupturing of the membrane is a well-recognized risk factor. The risk of the perinatal transmission is greatest when there is a florid primary infection in the mother. There is an appreciably smaller risk from the recurrent lesions in the mother, probably because of the lower viral load and the presence of a special antibody. The baby may also be infected from other sources such as the oral lesions from the mother to the herpetic with low nurse. A spectrum of neonatal HSV infection varies from the mild disease localized to the skin to a fatal disseminated infection. The infection is primarily dangerous in premature fetus. When dissemination occurs, the organ most commonly involved are the liver, adrenal, and the brain. Where the brain is involved, the prognosis is particularly severe. Encephalitis is a global and such severity, the brain may be liquefied. A large proportion of the survivors of neonatal HSV infection have residual disabilities. Acyclovir should be promptly given in all suspected cases of neonatal infection. The only means of prevention is often cesarean section. Other manifestations are the disseminated herpes simplex are much more likely to occur in immune-compromised individuals. These are the eczema, herpetiform, and hepatitis whitlow is there, and juxtiform herpes simplex. These are the rare presentations. What is the laboratory diagnosis? Direct detection by the electron microscopy may distinguish between HSV and varicella zoster. Immune fluorescence technique is there to distinguish it, and PCR is also there. Viral isolation is there. And serology is not that useful in acute phases that take 1 to 2 weeks for before antibodies appear from the infection. Now, what is the management at present? There is only a few indication of antiviral chemotherapy with the high cost of antiviral drugs being a main consideration. Generally, antiviral chemotherapy include the acyclovir, IV, oral, in local form and ophthalmic ointment are also there. Famiclovir and Velcovir. Other older drugs are also present there. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. It's all about the herpes simplex virus. I'm going to end this meeting. If you have any query, mention it in comment box. I will try to resolve it out.